I look crazy, y'all. It's late. It's like almost midnight here. Don't I look tired? It's been a long day. Anyway, so it's this dude on my friend's list, and he provides. Don't be laughing at me, girl. Okay, so he provides great content for me because, one, like, okay, it's like, I ain't gonna say that it's not people that don't have valid points. But I'm not finna be sitting up here doing no commentary with no dude because this is human behavior. You start talking about somebody on your Facebook list, people are going to go look for them. I'm not promoting none of these dudes running around here calling women bitches and I mean degrading women. Now, granted, I am one of these people that thinks that our society is fucked up because our women are fucked up. But that doesn't mean on no level I'm going to be promoting no dude running around here talking about this craziness when it's dudes out here that got issues themselves. But we ain't talking about them right now. I want to address this shit that this dude put on his page. Now, he knew some of my friends list. He just got on my friends list today. But I went through and I read the comments and dudes were respectful because I can respect that. So I wanted to go ahead and go live about the shit. Anyway, so he made two posts. First of all, for his post, I'm assuming, I don't really know this man like that. I'm assuming that he's single. Okay. So, the first post I saw, it said something to the effect of, what is required for a mate to be a housewife? Like, basically, what do women want for a man to be a housewife? What do women want in order to be a man's housewife? Is how I interpreted that. And the other question he asked was, and I don't know if it was really a question, but he was like, don't ever feed a man on a paper plate. Hold the fuck on. Hold the motherfucking dough now. Y'all know. Look, let me take this off because I look crazy. I probably look crazier with it off. I don't care. Anyway, let me tell you something. Let me take my jacket off. Let me get comfortable. Hold on. Get comfortable because I got to get into this because I don't appreciate somebody telling me not to feed no man on paper plate. You talking about being somebody housewife because nigga, look, now, let me tell you something. It's a lot that goes into being a homemaker, okay? Like, motherfuckers say we sit on our ass and watch TV all day. We wish, okay? We wish. People be always ask me, did you see this bit? Well, tell me exactly when I got time to watch TV, first of all. Now, maybe if my children were in school, I might have an opportunity to sit down and watch some TV. I homeschool as well, so maybe that might be it, but I don't know. They're going to go to school soon because they've asked and I finally decided to let them go. But until then, they're here. And maybe when they leave, it might be a different story. I highly doubt it. Because when you in the house all day, it ain't nothing but shit to do. It's always some shit to do. Okay? So, first off, foremost, 3 meals a day. 3 meals a day. You wake up at 5, 6 o'clock in the morning to make breakfast for everybody in the house. Or if you don't make breakfast for everybody in the house, you better make sure that the people that you made breakfast for eat that shit and that shit is gone before the second wave of folks wake the fuck up, okay? Because if they do not wake up, guess what you finna to do? You finna to make a whole nother breakfast. Let me tell you, sometimes my husband would get up and I would make breakfast with him. And then I would eat breakfast with him. And if I wasn't at that kitchen and done before them children woke up, guess what they want? They want breakfast. All of a sudden, cereal ain't good no more. Hot cereal ain't even gonna get it no more. They don't want none of that. They want some full breakfast. What y'all want to eat? We want pancakes and eggs and toast and jelly. Hold on. What? Okay, so you make this because this is your family and you love them. You want them to have nutritious meals, okay? So you go ahead and you make this. Now, mind you, everybody is eating off a regular plate. So after you get through with this regular plate and you done use this skillet, maybe a pot or whatever you use to make breakfast, okay, breakfast not that bad. Most times, it depends on how big your breakfast is. But you make this breakfast, you gotta go in there and wash the dishes. By the time you done feeding everybody and wash the dishes, maybe somewhere between 8 and 10, depending on what time you get up, Now your dishes is washed. If your dishes don't get done and finished until bring who on camera? The dude. Let me see if I can. Let me see if I can get him on. Hold on. Okay, he been invited. So, we'll see if he show up. Anyway, by the time you get through, if you don't get through with breakfast until 10 o'clock, by 11 o'clock, it's time for you to start making lunch. Okay? Now, lunch is typically a heavier meal than, okay, let me not say heavier. Lunch is actually kind of light, but lunch is more detailed, more intricate. So, where you might have just used a pot and a skillet for breakfast, now you're finna use two skillets, a pan, and a pot, and something else that you gonna have to wash. Not only do you have to wash that, you gotta put the butter up, put the seasonings up, put the paper up, put all that stuff up, and then you gotta wash these plates again. Do you know how many dishes you wash over and over and over and over again? Now, mind you, while you're making all of this food, you still got people eating some snacks, you still have people drinking. There are floors to be mopped, floors to be swept, floors to be vacuumed, beds to be made, laundries to be washed, laundries to be folded, children to talk to, homework to deal with, errands to run. It's a whole bunch of other shit you got to do in between washing all these dishes, but you still gotta wash these dishes. Okay, so you go ahead and you do your whole day, and you hopefully get to your lunchtime dishes before dinner time rolls around. Because everybody know when dinner time come around, it's going the fuck down. Do you understand? Dinner is the meal of the day, okay? That's when you put your heart, your soul, your everything into your food to prepare for your family so they have this not only somewhat nutritious meal, but they also... My bad, y'all. They also have this great tasting, wonderful cuisine that you put on. Hi, Shonda. Hi, Michael. Hi, Stephanie. How y'all doing? I'm going off right now because I was like, dude don't understand what he's talking about. Like, it's levels to this, okay? Like, I've been doing this for so long. I was like, bruh, I'm gonna need two things. I'll take one of them, but I'm gonna need something. I'm gonna need a Danny, okay? Or a housekeeper, because washing all these dishes three times a day, every motherfucking day, is a lot. That's a lot. Like, do you know how many times you put your hands in some dishwasher? And then after you put your hands in all this dishwater, you gotta wash your ass at the end of the night. Like, what? And then, oh my God! Let me tell y'all. He had the nerve, the unmitigated gall, to suggest that one of the rewards of cooking all these meals, and washing these dishes out of these meals, is some dick. What do you mean? What are you talking about? Wait a minute. So you mean to tell me that after I wash all these dishes and cook all this good, lovely food for you and made your belly full and gave you the itis, I'm talking about this is my food now. I know it's good and you eating it and you loving it and you got the itis. So you got the itis. I got the itis too. But because I got the itis and I'm the housewife and I'm the homemaker and I'm supposed to be the subservient one or the servant. Do you know what I'm talking about? Yes, ma'am. After all this, you want to reward me with more work? You want to reward me with more work? Because don't nobody want no boring ass bitch in bed. Don't nobody want no bitch laying there. Nobody want that shit. So now I gotta get up here and do all my tricks, work my magic, make the ass clap, jiggle it all around, jump it up and down, flip it, smack it, rub it down, all that. I gotta do all that after I done cook all these wonderful meals all day long because you think that you too good to be served on a paper plate. Let me tell you something. Paper plates save lives. Look, I just got up on the paper plate game. Like, for a long time, it's like, you don't serve people on a paper plate unless you at a cookout. It's a lot of people and all that. I would not do it. And then I start watching all these dishes, and I was like, bruh, there has to be more meaning to my life than washing dishes. Somebody make this shit stop. That's how the paper plates came in. They came in like, it was wonderful. It was like God came down and said, I have heard your cry, and I'm here to answer your prayer. And the answer to your prayer is this paper plate. Now, mind you, I don't get the fake-ass paper plates. I don't get the little cheap-ass bougie paper plates because I know my food is heavy. Don't nobody want to be eating. First of all, you eating on a paper plate. So that means if your food get good to you, you get a little over-aggressive or whatever, you happen to stab the plate, now you got juices and shit running out. Don't nobody want them kind of problems. I go ahead and I spend the extra dollar to get the good heavy plates. You can stab that one a couple of times before you get some juice. Now, if you stab that motherfucker and you get juice all over you and you spill your food in, you need to go to rehab because you have a problem, because you shouldn't be loving food that much. But, excuse me, y'all. But, spend the extra dollars to get the paper plates, and let me tell you something. It has made my dishwashing a much more enjoyable experience. You understand? Like, I just really got into the paper plates. Like, just got into the paper plates. And it's a wonderful thing. And the paper forks and spoons, too, because, you know, for some reason, when you got children in the house, yo, silverware just disappeared. It's the oddest thing. Like, you swear you checked the trash, but did you really check the trash? Because where are your silverware going? Are they eating the shit after they finish eating their meal? They like, oh, that was so good, I'm going to eat the silverware too. Your silverware just kind of disappears. So, you know, the plastic silverware kind of, you know, help you out twofold. Because, you know, you get the silverware, you get the paper plate. You ain't got to worry about it because you throw it away. You just going to buy new shit anyway. You know what I'm saying? If you recycle, you in there like swimwear. You Gucci two times. But, yes, I couldn't believe it. I was like, he was like, everybody don't have a servitude mindset. Bruh, didn't nobody sign up to be your servant, first of all? And if you get served a meal on a paper plate, be happy that you got served a meal at all. Do you know how much creativity, love, science, mechanics, knowledge goes into cooking? That's why y'all be cooking.